Hello everybody, welcome back to Scratch for Fun, and today we are back doing a little bit more modding. Sorry I was away this weekend, I had some business to be done. Not containing killing, just mentioning it. But yeah. So yeah, I can't remember what we did last time, but hopefully it made sense, it probably did. Now, let's open up our... Yes, we created a... not a chunk provider. We created a world provider last time, I believe. So we basically set our world chunk manager and we set our dimension ID. It should now basically be kind of able to create its own dimension basically. The only thing missing here is of course teleporting to this dimension and basically what's inside of this dimension. How do we want to provide the chunks? I'm not sure if you can call it so. But in our chunk provider void, it's basically that's the place we are going to work today. Now, I just wanted to mention that not all of this this stuff right here might make sense, at least not in the beginning, but once we get through it, it might make more sense, basically. So, we are just going to start very, very simple. We are going to create a constructor, because when you call it right here, we basically call this constructor. Now, what do we give it? We can give it a... we have a world object, so you know, in the world provider it has a world object, so we're going to give it the world object. We are also going to give this constructor the seed. It's not necessary to do it this way, you know, it can get it itself, but let's just give it the seed. That's what they've done in the source code. It, you know, it's a little bit easier to see that, you know, then you can basically provide with a custom seed. I guess that's one of the OOD principles. If you don't know what that is, who the hell cares, basically. But yeah, we're going to start on our constructor. So let's just hover over here. It says create a constructor. Let's create that constructor. And you know, it's created for us. Very, very awesome. We have a world object. We have a long, which is basically a kind of number with a seed. And then we have a boolean, which is basically set to true. Now, what does this boolean do? It basically adds features to this map, so we can call it features. There we go. So we are giving it a world object. We're giving it the seed, and we're giving it are you going to add features like caves and random stuff like that? If yes, yes. If no, no. Or false, rather. So we're basically going to save these objects. Then we of course need to create some, let's create a few variables here. Let's just create all of these privates, because, you know, who wants to get our variables? So we're going to create a private world, let's call this something like world, obj, because, you know, that's basically default. In our constructor, we are going to initialize this, so world obj is equal to world obj. Nope. OBJ, there we go. So now we created our world object. Now we need a private and we need a final boolean. The final basically means that it is always initialized, never null pointer. I believe you might be able to set it to null. Features enabled. But it basically means that either it's initialized here, right out on the spot where it's created, or it is initialized in the constructor, which is the first thing that happens. So we're basically going to say this dot map features enabled equal to features. There we go. We want features in our game. You know, it's as simple as that. Now we're also going to have a lot of these noise generators, but before that we are going to add a and of course this will make more sense as we go along. I'll explain more when it when I believe it makes the most sense. Oh, that's not supposed to go in there. That's supposed to go in there. And then we need a private another double array. Let's give this a stone noise. We're going to set it equal to new double. It's not only it's not, you know, we might change some of these numbers again once we are finished, once we get a little bit more look at it and thinks, you know, oh, this is clearly wrong. So we're going to get a map gen base, cave generator. This is basically how you create a default Minecraft world. If there is anything you want to customize, I will go through how you can do that and how you can add multiple stuff. Oh, but once again, it makes more sense once we are finished. So we're map gen base, and let's import that. This should also be imported. It's from the same package, I believe. Now let's jump in here. You can see here, the map gen base. You know, there's rather in map gen caves. There is, you know, generates caves and stuff like that. So that's, you know, important to have if you want caves. Now I also want a stronghold, so I'm going to say map gen and then stronghold. I want a stronghold in my world. If you don't want a stronghold, this I'm basically adding a lot of features so that if you want a stronghold in your world, you know, not that you necessarily want one, and of course we're going to add the, you know, create features like this ourselves. So map gen stronghold, but if you want a stronghold, I'll basically show you how you can add a stronghold. And if you want villages in your villages, there we go. If you want villages in your world, then we're going to create a generator for our villages. Let's set it equal to new map gen village. There we go. That needs to be imported as well. Village, there we go. And just so we don't need to import everything, let's just switch that out with a star. Because a village is a structure. Map gen village, I guess. And then we're going to create a another private map gen, and then scattered feature. There we go. Let's call this scatter. Let's just copy that name. And let's add a generator at the end because it makes sense. Generator. A little bit cold on my fingers today. Let's set it equal to a new map gen scattered feature. There we go. Let's import that as well. It's in gen feature, so for the future ones we'll add a star there. Then we want ravines, of course. So map gen, and once again scattered features. It will make more sense once we create this generator or kind of use it, I guess. So map gen ravine. There we go. What else do we want? Well, we want some biomes, I guess. Private biome gen base. Then we're basically going to say biomes for generation. There we go. Generation. I guess so. Then let's import biome gen base, and then we want a few noises, you know, we'll go through that more into detail once we get it. And then we also want to kind of initialize these Maduhekis right here. So a way we're going to do this, we're going to just add this Maduheki right here. We're basically opening up something, I guess. And you know, if you're familiar with the Java, I guess it's a little bit easier to understand. But what we basically need is we need some stuff created first, I guess. This is how vanilla Minecraft does it. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab our cave generator, going to set it equal to terraingen.getModdedMapGen. We're going to give it a cave generator. We are also going to give it a tag. That's not where I wanted to write. A tag called as much as cave. Then let's grab our stronghold. It does not make very much sense with the word cave here. Why is it so? Well, it will probably make more sense in the future, I guess, to this program of ours. Then we're going to create a stronghold generator, or we're going to initialize it. We're going to say map gen stronghold, and we're going to set this equal to terrain gen dot get modded map gen, and then we are once again going to say that's not where I want to write. Stronghold generator and then stronghold, I guess. You know, it's very, very simple. Now, the reason we're getting errors here is, believe I, because we need to statically import something. That basically means that you can use the methods and variables without actually referring to it. So terrain gen get modded map gen. If we were to statically import terrain gen, we didn't, you know, need to write this right here, I believe, at least. That's as far as I've gotten. So we're going to import a static net.minecraft and then forge.event, and then we're going to jump down to terrain gen, and then we're going to go into init map gen event, and then we're going to say as much as event type. And that basically means that we can now statically use some of those. We're going to copy this line of code, paste it down once again. So populate and then chunk event. That's another event. And then we're going to end that with dot populate dot event type. And if we spell that correctly, which we probably didn't, there we go. Remove unused import. Well, it's going to be used in the future, I guess, so we might as well leave it in there. Now, while we are getting errors here, we will check out in a second, I guess. But let's just continue down the line here. So let's get our village going. Let's get our scattered feature generator going, and let's get our ravine going as well. There's probably a lot more if you jump into the class, or I guess the package. How do you check that out? Well, you can probably go to MapGen base and see, oh, netminecraft.world.gen. Let's go into net.minecraft.world.gen, and here, you know, you got some stuff you can generate. There's probably some more. In under features, there's probably some more here, and then you have structures. There's some structures here that you can generate and other stuff like that. Let's jump back here, I guess. Now let's initialize the final ones here. So once again, we are using terrain gen, and we are doing dot get modded map gen, and then we are giving it our village terrain, and then once again, and we are using this village tag, which we need to statically import, I guess. And then we need to set this equal to terrain gen dot get modded world type, get modded map gen, and then we need to do scattered feature, and then we are basically doing, what's the tag for that? It's just scattered underscore feature, and then we need to do this last one, which is this right here, terrain gen dot get modded map gen, and we're going to give it our ravine, and then we're going to say ravine. Now there are some stuff here that is not working out how we want it to, and it is something up in our event type right here. Why does it not like our, we do have these modules right here, we have statically imported it, so I'm not sure why it dislikes that. I'm not sure, probably event type dot cave, that works. We have probably forgotten something at the end here. We forgot the dot and then the star. The same for this event type down here. My bad. And then we need to, let's uncomment this right here. That's you know, that's how wrong you can go. So let's remove that right there. Now we do get some errors here. We need to cast some stuff here. Let's get our map. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Map gen village. Let's cast this right here to a map gen village. Then we're going to cast scattered feature. And why we're doing this, I'm going to explain a little bit later once we kind of get it and know what this is all about. I think we missed one. Mineshaft generator. We need to generate mineshafts as well. So let's jump in here, I guess. Private. And then we're going to say as much as map gen mineshaft. That's not how I spell it. It's a H in there. And then let's call it mine shaft. There we go. Generator. Let's set it equal to new map gen. And then mine. Mine shaft. There we go. If you take it slowly, it works. Let's grab this mine shaft. Set it equal to. Let's cast it. The stuff we get out here to a train. gen.getModdedMapGen. We're going to give it our mineshaft, and we are going to use the tag now. Now we have all the tags down here. Mineshaft. There we go. So we've now initialized all of these right here. Very, very awesome. Very, very swell. And now, I guess there's not very much left to do. For this episode at least, let's, while we're at it, create a random. Now, this random right here is basically going to be our random. So let's just call it private random. And then this is basically the same random we're going to use through the entire dimension. And what we're basically doing is we're grabbing this random right here. And then we're going into... Where is it? Into our chunk provider down here, and we're going random. And then we are... Let's say this actually. So this dot random is equal to a new random, and we're giving it given the random a seed. Now that's the way Minecraft generates. It uses a random, but the random is not actually very random. It is calculated. You can give this random a seed, which basically means that it will always give out the same numbers. You know. If I use this for the first time, it's going to give me that. And next time I use it for the first time, it's going to give me the same random number. So it's not very, very random, but it is random enough for us. So that basically means that we can recreate maps if we give it the same random. It's basically the same random. This random generates that numbers, you know. That's how it goes. So I guess that's everything we managed to do in this episode right here. We're going to go a little bit more down into, I guess, noise generators next episode. So yeah, stay tuned for that if there is something, you know, you didn't understand. And of course, there probably will, because we are going to go through... you know, it's going to be a lot of code to write. It will not make sense, you know, before we've written that code. Why do we have mineshaft generators, you know, to generate mineshafts? Well, it's going to be, you know, kind of... When we get into the populate method and, you know, stuff like that, you know, it's going to make a whole lot more sense. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, everybody. My name is Scratchfan. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button, and I'll catch you all guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.